Well, we tried to figure out a way and a time to do this, and we were planning obviously on doing it Friday night, and it rained and rained, and so we're glad that we've got the sunshine this morning. Before we start, let's pray. Father, thank you for this morning and this bright sunshine, and thank you for the rain that we've had and the reminder that it's a blessing from you, and we're grateful for the blessings of you in our lives, and we're grateful for the blessings of you in Ryan's life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So, we're glad, you know, obviously, that Ryan's got a mom and dad that care about him and an extended family, and obviously another set of grandparents that care about not just him in a loving family way, but also in a way that is mindful of his spiritual need. And so that's kind of why we were happy that Ryan asked Mike and me to baptize him here today.
You know, there's nothing supernatural about baptism. It's derived from ancient cleansing rituals. It was celebrated in many cultures. It's not a guarantee of salvation, and it doesn't forgive sins, because Jesus himself was baptized, and he certainly never sinned. What it is an outward expression of an inner change. It's a demonstration that happens. It's a change of heart. It happens when you make a conscious decision to follow Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So, Jesus himself, in some of the last words he spoke on earth, gave us the Great Commission, where he said, "Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe all that I've commanded you." And, you know, when we think of baptism, we think of a couple of other events. One in history, the Last Supper, and one to come, the marriage of the Lamb. Marriage of the Lamb is when Jesus will be physically and eternally united with his church. So, when we consider marriage, you know, all marriages, Michael and Kelsey's, which we so joyfully celebrated yesterday, and all marriages should be a reflection of the love that Jesus has for his church. So,
well, I guess I'd add to that too, that, you know, we've got the marriage of the Lamb, we've got communion, we've got communion that represents Christ, his forward looking to the cross. And then we've got baptism that certainly is an opportunity for us to express our faith. And Ryan, it's an opportunity for you to express your faith. And I remember your mom made a record of a conversation that you guys had on the 10th of June 2006, when you were 5 years old. And even then, you guys were in an airplane, and you were talking about flying to heaven, and you were talking about other things, and I think even then it expressed your faith, it expressed your understanding to some extent of righteousness and a need in your heart. And I think it was totally appropriate, given the Breutsch legacy, that it was done in an airplane. And of course, today we're here to finish what that step of faith that you first took in 2006.
Yeah, even at 5 years old, Ryan, we know you had a concept of heaven and forgiveness, and you started to understand what it is to follow Jesus. So, today, do you still trust in Jesus as your Savior?
The other thing I'd say, too, is that, you know, Jesus wants us to be obedient. He demands our obedience, and with faith comes obedience. And even in the short span of our lives, the manner of our lives matter to the Lord. So we're going to baptize you here today, but before we do that, this is a chance for you to express anything that you want to.
I just wanted to thank everybody for coming. I mean, this is kind of interesting how this worked out with the wedding and all that, but I'm glad everybody could still stay for this day with the baptism. So
you're ready, huh? Okay. All right.
Well then, considering that confession of faith and the obedience that you've already started to show, it's our honor to baptize you, our little brother in Christ, in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Buried with Christ in baptism.
And raised to walk in life with him.
All right.